The August 2022 release of SAP Cloud Application Programming Model, that's CAP to you and me, is out. There's plenty for us to get our teeth into in this release, including items related to CAP on Kima and Kubernetes, the CDS language and compiler, VS Code support for CDS configuration, the Java SDK, and also the Node.js runtime, which include important changes, not least the removal of an undocumented way to make queries using unqualified names in the CDSQL context. The removal, along with recommendations on how to do these queries properly, is documented in the release notes, along with lots of other detail. You can check out the release notes in the usual place, the CAPIA documentation. The link is in the description. Happy hacking.
SAP Data Intelligence Cloud Edition 2208 has been released. Among changes that should be interesting for those of you developing data pipelines should be the new integration with the Git version control. You can use the built-in Git terminal to integrate file-based SAP Data Intelligence content, such as graphs, operators, Docker files, or script code with an existing Git server. You can keep a version history of changes and collaboratively work with other developers by sharing content files in Git. As well, the release 3.3 of SAP Data Intelligence on-premises edition is now available. One important change in data pipelines modeling there is that Python version 3.9 is now the default in the Python sub-engine. Python version 3.6 is removed since it has officially reached its end of life. There is one more new feature I would like to mention. You can activate SNC or secure network communication for RFC when using an ABAP legacy connection, so that you can create a connection to the legacy ABAP on-premise or ECC system in a secure way with encryption. More details about both releases are in blog posts published by the product management.
Hi everyone. A couple of days ago, Vridi Shetty posted a really cool two-part blog series on AI Core and AI Launchpad. Both blog posts are made up of text and short video segments, each showing a different step of the end-to-end machine learning lifecycle process. The videos are great, short and to the point, so you get the information you actually need for that step. The first part of the blog post covers the configuration, including getting a service key, creating a workspace, connecting to your GitHub, your Docker, and to your S3 bucket, as well as the training of your model and the underlying steps, such as registering a training artifact, publishing your training Docker image, creating, configuring, and executing your training workflow. The second part of the blog post series covers the serving of your model, which is quite similar to the training workflow, and the managing of your machine learning use case, which includes monitoring your metrics and updating your deployments. The blog post series focuses on using AI Launchpad to do all the steps, but as always, you can also access AI Core via the AI API and the AI Core SDK. If you want to try out more specific use cases, then we also have a lot of AI Core tutorials available on the SAP tutorials page.
Hi everyone. The UI theme designer recently got an update, as the new Horizon theme family was added to the list of available base themes and is now generally available. The team created a pretty cool video showing how you can design your own themes and apply them to your SAP applications. The link is in the description.
Open source engagement at SAP goes back a long way. I remember in the 90s, SAP making contributions to the Linux kernel in the area of memory management to get SAP R3 to run on that platform. Over the decades since, SAP has been involved in the open source community, both consuming and making open source software contributions. SAP's Open Source Program Office, OSPO, has recently set up a network of open source champions to help amplify their internal activities. In Ulrika's blog post, SAP Open Source Champions, you can get to know who they are, what they do, and where they are. Check out all the details and get to know these new open source champions in the blog post, linked in the description.